Yeah, oh yeah, it'd be great.
Be being all,
yeah,
being
sure.
all peaceful on a Sunday morning.
There ain't nothing like that's peaceful. There ain't nothing
on
like
it.
That.
See, we really adjusted here. Yeah, I know, but we were getting no sound.
Oh, they don't have sound?
There wasn't when this was attached, so I can catch this.
Okay, and maybe we should have sound.
Where'd we go?
Now we're good.
That's too far too
late. So we're just gonna have to be cut out through the camera. That's what happens when I come to see.
That's for the event last night for his share of the proceeds.
Thank you.
Happy Sunday, everybody. Happy Sunday. Whoa. I'm loving all the summer colors. It's arrived. Summer's here. Beautiful weather outside. I'm Chris Berente, a member here. Just some announcements. I'm trying to listen to you. And then we'll get the service started. Of course, the room, I better check myself. Get on the phone to make sure it's in airplane mode or turn it all the way off. That's the best thing. We've had some very poorly timed ring-a-dings. We don't want to ring a ding during a sacred moment, so go ahead and remember one ring a ding, murder. So silence your phones if you can. No open food in here, but if you have a drink, that's fine. Just keep it covered. Morning, boys in the back. How are you? Are you guys brothers? I thought so. Good to see you. We do have, for those who can't be here on Sunday, we have our community connections on Zoom. Zoom is still a thing. That's every Thursday. 11 to 12:30. That allows folks who may not be able to get here to stay connected. You're more than welcome to join if you want a little midweek dose of spirituality. I want to remind everybody that we're really proud of our kitchen and our ability to have lunch every Sunday. That doesn't simply manifest. We get to make it manifest. That means we need volunteers, both for the setup and for the cleanup after. I love doing it. I like to sing back there, you might hear me when I sing. And case in point, when we don't have enough volunteers or when the kitchen staff falls through, we don't get lunch. And that's a really important chance for us to come together. This Sunday we had an issue with our chef, and so we're not able to have lunch today. I'm bummed about it. I know you are too. The way we can get around that is to up our volunteers. You can see Luis way back there, or any of our folks here at church. If you'd like to sign up, is the sign-up sheet in the kitchen. So there's a bulletin board right as you walk into the community hall. You can sign up. It's fun, doesn't take much time. We need help before, we need help after. And today, because we don't have lunch, I did notice about 12 dozen donuts in there. You can still get your sugar buzz. Bavarian cream filled with a favorite. That'll be after service today. Want to remind you, speaking of after service, that we have our prayer partners available so that if you need some maybe private prayer, some affirmative prayer in a more intimate setting. We offer that every Sunday. It's a beautiful space for healing. And as usual, Mike, where's Connie? Oh, there they are. Our prayer partners. They're wonderful people, and they can help. They can help. So they'll be doing it in Darwin's Den right after service today. We're working to grow our membership, and we've streamlined it. So if you've come here once or twice, you're thinking, maybe I'd like to be a member. There is no secret initiation process. It's a simple conversation to get you signed up, and it matters for our church. So anybody after service who's a regular, wave your hand if you're a regular here. Come on now, yeah. You can talk to them. They'll get you hooked up and get you to be a member. Also, is Linda here today? Our yoga expert extraordinaire. I've taken Linda's yoga, and it is such an amazing, it's like a spiritual retreat combined with the positions. And this time she's doing it focusing on the feminine. So this course that she's doing now, it's called Women's Somatic Sanctuary. It is for women only. So I'll be watching through the window and very jealous. Don't be creeped out. But if you want to sign up for that, all the information's on our website. I highly recommend it. It's a 4-week course. Heather, a heartfelt medium, and Rick, a Finbo, a psychic, are back today at 1. So after you have some donuts, maybe grab a little lunch, you can come back at 1 p.m. There we go. A howl. Okay, a howl. There it is. I didn't see there. It's $33 and includes all kinds of opportunities to provide clarity and purpose in your life. They're going to bring an afternoon of surprise and delight. I've seen Rick's spoken here before. Very powerful guy. So get those tickets. You can talk to him after Mass. In it, at Mass, can you tell me Catholic? Do I have to do a rosary for that? All right, and then also at 12:30 in Darwin's Den, Reverend Christina and her friend Junia are going to have, I've seen them post this. You posted it all across social, and you piqued my interest. You've probably heard Reverend Christina talk about her trip to Peru and how it changed her life. And you thought, man, why didn't she invite me? I'd like to have my life changed. Well, it's going to happen now. It's going to happen. And this is the early stages of talking with her about getting a group together and going to Peru. How cool would that be? It's going to be called Quickening into the Light Journey. So at 12:30, if you're interested, think maybe I'd like to go. Now is a chance to get the ball rolling and start to talk about that. I think I've covered everything, yeah? I got the thumbs up from Ricky. That means yes, I have. So if you will help me now, speaking of Reverend Christina, welcome her to the stage now. A beautiful blessing for our church, Reverend Christina Jones.
Thank you, Chris. Good morning, everyone. Thank you, Leonard, for being here. As we hear him sing with a voice. Welcome to LDS Center. We are a non-denominational spiritual center and a non-judgmental center. Recently, someone said that God doesn't like gay people. God, my creator, I say supreme being, loves everyone. And we practice that. This building has been created by four powerful women in a new thought movement. And they practice affirmative prayer, oneness. And we are not a conversion spiritual center. We are containing our own Catholicism as the promise for the show up here. And bring it all into the oneness. We provide tools. And this beautiful building that was created over 100 years ago stands upon the land of the Arapaho, Cheyenne, and Ute people. Divine energy, divine love, and divine joy. So we do practice what we preach. We stand and believe in a statement of all. That is one life, one God, and one me. Welcome to Althea. So anyone that's here for the first time, raise your hand. Welcome! Welcome. Like we said, we don't have lunch today, but if you come back, tell Ricky that you get a free lunch. They remember Christina said I get a free lunch next time I come home. And we will honor that. And someone will come by, myself, or one of our amazing board members, will come by again. Thank you so much for being. And now Connie is our amazing practitioner, along with her husband, Mike, will be praying us in. You look at me. She's so bright and sunny today. I love it.
Speaking of that.
That's okay. Drop into your heart. Just know that right here, right now, you have come to that place of knowingness, that aliveness that God is here right now, present in this room, in this part of your life. This absolute beingness that is so alive and so wonderful. And so as you know that that is present, and take that next breath and move into the truth that that is what created each one of us. That is what is creating this existence in this building, in this world. As we open our hearts and say yes to the goodness that already is. And so I claim that goodness. I claim that in my life, in this moment, in the words that Reverend Christina is going to share with us, in the music that's going to be unfolded with us, in the opportunity to give a hug or to get a hug, in the smiles, in all that takes place in the next hour. For there is so much love and so much joy in this sanctuary, in this building, in this community. And I claim that all as good. And I say thank you. Thank you, God, for the opportunity to be part of this, to allow you to move through me, as me, and open my life up to the good that is already present. And I let it go. And I know it is so. In deep, deep respect, I know it is already done. The joy has been named, it's been claimed, and it's unfolded. Right here, right now. And so I let it be. So is.
Amen.
Beautiful honey. Thank you. And now we're going to do a statement of being, which was written in the early 1900s. I invite you, if you're willing and able, to stand. And the statement of being is coming up next week. And together we say, God is love,
both invisible and visible,
one presence, one mind,
one power is all.
This one who has all
is perfect life, perfect love, and perfect substance. We are the individualized expressions of God, and everyone one is perfect life, perfect love, and perfect substance.
And now, Ricky and my husband, Red Jones, will be singing The Face of God. Such a gift. is acclaimed actor for theater performances, The Denver Boulder, Fort Collins since 2004, winning many regional awards for his performances. Leonard is also a frequent performer with the Colorado Symphony and Cabaret shows. And when we ask, what's his favorite thing to do is to sing at senior communities. Beautiful souls, welcome back, Leonard Miller.
It is by the process of resurrection that we rise out of the contemplation of that which is hidden, the mysteries, as we have called these, into the full light where everything is made clear. There is nothing hidden that shall not be revealed to the one who sees the unity of life. We are rising into a recognition of the glory of process when we stand before a blade of grass and see that even this is wonderful.
Thank you, Bruce. Stand before a blade of grass, the sun, and know its joy. Joy brings us to the present moment. I believe it's the brother or sister to love. Now, some people may ask me, and I've recently had, how can you be joyful with everything that's going on in the world? Last week, and this whole month, I'm talking about joy. Last week was about joy as in the journey. And boy, what a journey we are on. But there is joy in the journey. Part of that journey that we are currently on, when you're in it, when you're present to it, that's the now. That's the present moment. I love that Eckhart Tolle talks about the power of that. And too many of us are pasteurizing, living in the past. Everyone is speculating. I'm reading a book right now called Creating. And there's a section called Speculation. And it's futuration speculation. I got a new term. We are a speculation nation. We speculate all the time. And some of that speculation is in the future and nothing's happened. But the present moment, right here, is all we have. And right here creates this. Think about that. More and more people are getting addicted to social media. It's really scary. The other day, I watched a woman do this with her phone, and cars were coming. I called, she's in a Keith Super's parking lot, and she was out, and then I saw the earbuds. And thank goodness, this guy in this huge truck, he jumps out of his truck, puts his hands up to me, I'm like, I got it. He's like, wait! She dropped her phone. And then in shock, all of us are strangers, but not really strangers in the oneness. She cried. He held her. That was joy. And he's like, you could have gotten killed. Get off that phone. She was unaware. And I believe that was divine timing. As any other people, if we were not present, she may not be here. So we need to release the speculation nation, especially what's going on in this political season. Oh my goodness. I heard that Vegas is taking bets on political season. Let's not get there and get back to the present moment. And I'm not saying to ignore the past. We can't ignore the past. Jorge Luis Delgado is one person that has helped change my life. Hence why I'm going back to Peru and taking the group. He's been on Ancient Aliens. You can Google him. Amazing. Amazing man that grew up in Lake Titicaca, and you want to see poverty. He has surpassed that energetic. One of the things from one of his books, Cling to the Past and Excuse, designed to bring forth the uniqueness of our gifts towards an evolution of life. Clinging to the past. He also says, if we don't, I'm paraphrasing, if we do not heal our past is like this, right here, and all the way in the future. So I'm not saying ignore the past. It's time for us to affirm, which we do in these teachings, a new present moment to create a new future. I read this book called Choices, written by Dr. Edith Eden. She was taken into Auschwitz at 16. She watched her parents be gassed. They found her alive, a soldier did. A German soldier found her body in a pile of bodies. And he could see she was still alive, her back was broken. He picked her up and got her out. Her book Choices is about finding joy in pain. She wrote about that even though her parents and all the atrocities that were going on during that time, she found joy in stealing a piece of bread. She found laughter in the pain. And as that soldier did save her life and hit her and got her help, they maintained the friendship. I think she's still alive. I think she's around 91. She talks about finding joy in the pains of our past. So if she can do that, imagine what we can do. To not allow us to get wrapped into whatever is going on the planet. Whatever they, whoever they are, may say. To hold on to truth. To learn. To make a choice of what I learned, of what we learned in the past. Today is bittersweet for me. Today, I think, would be my daddy's 86th birthday, June 9th. I know six people with his birthday. June 9th is always a special and sad day, because I wish he was still here, since I did take a long time to work on forgiveness. But my joy is that no matter what we went through in our childhood, let's find that bit of joy in the challenge. When I was in Peru, it did change my life. I took over my middle name. I've released, for me, all my energies. I was still working on some healing, but I became more aware. And Jorge is amazing, intuitive, that this was in 2014, and he said, you need to stop ignoring going to ministerial school. I was like, who told me that? You need to stop ignoring what you're called to be and write that book. We need to stop ignoring and come back to the present moment of what we're called to be. All of us have a mission, if not more than one, many missions. And one of those missions, I do believe, is spreading joy, despite what's going on. Last week, I talked about the word mourning. As we mourn losses of old behaviors, friends, family. But the new mourning is that light, that joy does come in. And then brings us back to the present moment. So right now, I'm going to take everyone through a small little exercise. I'm going to invite you and those of you watching online or even later on. If you're willing, gently close your eyes and think of a joyful time in a summertime you enjoyed as a kid or a teenager. It might be even last year. And take a deep breath. The breath brings us to peace. Get an image or feeling. And make it a smile on your face. some of you, if you will, raise your hand if you have a feeling. So when things show up, that's the present moment. You can't go back to the joyful, loving parts of our parents. And you can bring that to the present moment. And thank you. Eckhart Tolle, as soon as you are in the present moment, all unhappiness and struggle dissolve. Life begins to flow with joy and ease. Some of you all know I experienced homelessness as a teenager. And one thing that has always triggered me is when we had a company layoff, or when I was an engineer, all 2,000 of us were let go in one day after 9/11. Emotionally and physically, I felt my body seize up because I went into fear. I got out of the present moment. I was all over here. I'm going to lose this. I'm not going to have this. I even forgot some of these teachings. Forgot what I was affirming. Because even though I was freaking out, I was actually futurizing, speculating, like, oh my God. And I called my mom. I was freaking out. She's like, breathe. She said, you're going to have a panic attack. Breathe. Just because you went through this, look what you accomplished. You owned two homes. Duh. The time I owned two homes. I made a point not to have credit card debt. She's like, honey, do you have kids? Are you financially taking care of me right now? I said, no. She brought me back to what it is. Presence. And I grieved. And I was having so much fun. And I just like, can I come see you? She said, sure. Made me a lunch. She said, I want you to do something fun today. I called a girlfriend who just lost her job to you. And I said, you know what, let's go to Black Hawk. Some of you may not know what Black Hawk is. It's our mountains of casinos. And I'm not a big gambler, but I'm like, I need to do something jarring. And we had fun. We were driving up the hill, listening to music. I said, we're not going to talk about work. We're not going to go into what may happen and what's going on with the world. We're not going to go into fear. I said, we're going to have fun. She said, well, yeah, but I thought we'll make it come. My kind of my limit is to lose $50. But I said, we'll just see it as a payment of fun, a payment of joy. We had so much fun. She won $10,000. I won $3,000. I was like, woo! And what I realized was my mom and my aunt, very mystical women, they're like, because you shifted your energy into fun and joy. Despite everything else. So that's what my intention to motivate not only you but myself of when we see and hear things, when people say, God doesn't like me anymore, God doesn't like this person, God doesn't like this, and that, and that, and that, and that. Spirit created all of us out of love and joy. We only manifest when you're happy. You only manifest when you're happy. How many of you have seen the witches of Eastwick? So when they were trying to fly, in order so they didn't crash, what did they have to do? They had to laugh. And the laughter helped them from crashing into the ground. That's joy. We can bring joy. Like that beautiful Dr. Edith Eaton. She found joy in unbelievable trauma. That's her mission on this planet. She believes, she said, I have no idea. She believes in her, what she calls God, the divine creator. And she said, I don't know if I take this journey, but obviously, without that journey and all that pain, she found joy. So if she did it, so can we. That's what we're called to do when we're in the present moment. Be in a joy and laughter moment. Sometimes make a joke or watch something funny on TV. Affirm it. Because then we do get to change our own circumstances. And when we change our own circumstances, We change energy. We change our frequency. Just like when that guy grabbed that woman that all of us could have easily hit. She got aggressive. And the tears, it wasn't fear. I saw it was a gratitude in her life. She waved at all of us saying, thank you, thank you. It brought her right back. We don't need a spiritual 2x4 to put us in the present moment. They hurt, I want her. We're to hold on to it. Even if you're new here, take anything you've learned from, say, religion and spirituality and bring it into that, affirming. I grew up metaphysical, but I also grew up Catholic, Methodist. I had an uncle, a Jehovah's Witness. It was the whole gamut. Now, for me, what got me deeper into spirituality, and I still lean into some of that, I leave the fear behind. I leave the judgment behind. When I say we welcome everyone, we welcome everyone. I live that. I always have. We have to be in joy for humanity. It is critical. We are required. I think about all the speculation nation, and it got me thinking about the mental health crisis we have. A lot of it, when people tell me they're having a moment, it's stuff that hasn't happened. Who knows what's going to happen? Let's release the speculation and tap into that golden light of that oneness frequency of whatever you call God or Christ consciousness. To be in that. Know thyself. For 2 days I was in a personality workshop. I have to do workshops because I would be a hypocrite if I come on stage and did my own work. And discovered some of my personality that brought tears to my eyes because I hid from me. Been hiding from me. And I joyfully do stand into it because I've been laughing. It made me laugh about the funny things I did as a child. And I'm sure all of us had funny quirks about ourselves. So that's the past we go into. And when Orion talks about clinging on to the past, well, even the old energies that may have been challenging old relationships with churches, friends, family, jobs that cause discomfort, maybe it's time to go back to just heal it and say, in the present moment, what did I learn? Just look where I am now. So you take the lessons and you bring it to the present to create a beautiful, powerful, joyful future. Do not take on the world. We can send love and light, but do not get pulled into it. It's designed to pull you into it. That's a lower frequency. Spirit, God, universal force, is all love, all joy, our uniqueness, all creativity. That is who we are. Do what brings you joy. Catch yourself this month, because this is going to be a lot of stuff. All the way through the election, not just in politics, everything. Catch yourself and do like, you know what, I need a break and I'm going to have a joyful break. Not just a mental health break, a joyful break. Even the word mental health, even me as a counselor, starting to hurt me because some people are like, you don't want to have mental problems. Let's say joyful. Let's change that wording. And I'm not ignoring that people do go through emotional crisis. There's mental illness that I grew up with in my family. I'm not ignoring that. I believe in a prayer and a pill. But what I'm saying is don't say, oh my God, I don't have a mental health thing. When I hear people don't like it, joyful thing. Do what brings you joy. That breath, that meditation. I said last week, if you don't have 5 minutes to meditate, you need 10. If you're watching, binge watching Netflix, trust and best believe, you need to be breathing. take a moment of time and joy. So now we're going to take a moment. As a joyful sign of me, I took that picture in the room that I love taking pictures of flowers. And that brings me joy. This June, as we do celebrate Father's Day, if you choose, LGBTQ month, Juneteenth, or any birthday or holiday, or anything you remember from June, as a teenager or young adult, breathe into that. Breathe into that. And let it wash over you. Because what's washing over you is Spirit, is God. The divine creator that created all of us in love and oneness, because love and joy and peace and harmony is truly all there is. And that goes beyond AI. That goes beyond social media. It is all of us. So now I invite you, if you're willing, to take a deep breath. And joyfully, I know, Spirit is all there is. That divine force known by no name and all names, for we are all in a divine unity of joy. And I know that for everyone here on in LBO, logically, or aligned with the entire planet, that no matter the outside conditions, inside joy and golden love and light that flows through every sentient being. Joy is in the bumblebee and in the butterfly. Joy reigns, love reigns, honesty and purity, and we are all mighty warriors of joy. And we stand in that peace and that place with that higher light, that higher consciousness, if you will, of joy and holding a loved one's hand, and the joy of a baby's smile, the joy that we wake up every morning and we can feel into our bodies, the joy of friendship, all of that is energetic love. And I'm grateful for it. I'm grateful for everyone here, and I'm grateful for every sentient being. And I release this into divine law, where it is complete. It is joyful, it is loving, it is sweet and kind. And together we say, and so it is.
There we go. Good morning. My name is Leonard Barr. Beautiful message, Christina. Got another song for you. There's so much to be thankful.
find out truth. It's all long overdue. So for tonight, we pray for what we know can be.
Also, there's a thank you, Jason.